Hi, I'm Yanchen Lin, and in this video, I'll present Nerve Supervision, an RGB-only pipeline that learns dense object descriptors from neural radiance fields. Here, we show that our method endows robot the ability to pick and place forks on the dining table with 6 degrees of freedom. This task is challenging because common kitchen items like forks are reflective and don't work well with RGBD cameras. For the dining table scene, the RGBD camera perceives the incorrect geometry of forks as highlighted in the red box. This poses difficulties for state-of-the-art pick-and-place methods because they rely on RGBD cameras to collect correspondence data that is then used to train the perception model. In contrast, our method Nerve Supervision is a pipeline for generating correspondence data with RGB-only sensors, and it works better than classic techniques like multi-view stereo, as we'll show later. Nerve supervision consists of three steps. First, we need to create a nerve of the object that we're interested in. We start by collecting multi-view RGB images of the object. Then, we apply structure from motion to recover the camera poses and the sparse point cloud of the scene. Although the original nerve formulation only requires post-RGB images as supervision, we found that incorporating supervision from the sparse point cloud mitigates the noise caused by moving shadows during the image capturing process. On the right-hand side, we visualize the RGB and depth images rendered by the nerve model. For comparison, we visualize the depth map predicted by COMAP, a widely used multi-view stereo library. The estimated depth map is low quality because the thin and reflective nature of common kitchen items makes it challenging for multi-view stereo to match pixels based on patches similarities. The second step of our pipeline is to generate a dense correspondence dataset from NERF. We'll use two views to explain the idea, but it can be easily generalized to multiple views. First, we use NERF to synthesize two RGB images of the scene. For clarity, let's zoom in on the left image. If we shoot a 3D ray into the magenta pixel, it can be visualized as the 2D epipolar line on the other image. We'll also zoom in on the right image as well to explain the following steps. Along the 3D ray, we sample points and use NERF to predict their densities. Sample points are shown in green circles. The larger the circle, the higher the predicted density. A naive strategy is to use the weighted average of these 3D points based on their densities to derive dense correspondence. However, we show that this strategy leads to the wrong correspondence, visualized as the red cross. To avoid this issue, we propose to keep all sample points and sample them as correspondence probabilistically based on their densities. The final step of our pipeline is to train a dense correspondence model. There's no limitation on the model architecture, so users can use their favorite model for this step. In this project, we use the correspondence model proposed in Florence et al. On the left, we show the input RGB image. On the right, we show the segmented RGB image and the dense descriptors predicted by our dense correspondence model. Since the descriptors are dense, we can arbitrarily select key points and track them. In these examples, we show three key points that are colored in red, green, and blue. We note that this is more flexible than most key point detection methods because one can decide which points to track during the test time. The tracked 2D key points with stereo image pairs help us derive their 3D locations and 6 degrees of freedom grasp poses for accurate pick and place. In this example, the model was trained only on the medium-sized fork, but the descriptors also work accurately for both smaller and larger forks at test time. This enables our robot to manipulate forks that are not in the training data. Of course, it doesn't just work on forks. One can reuse the same pipeline for other challenging objects, like strainers. Here, we show that the robot can collect the strainers from the dish rack with 60 graffiti pick in place. Again, in this example, we only trained the descriptor model on the medium-sized strainer, but it generalized to strainers of different sizes and styles, which enables the robot to manipulate them. In summary, NERF supervision is an RGB-only pipeline that uses NERF to supervise dense correspondence models. We show that this pipeline enables robot to manipulate challenging objects that are otherwise not possible. Thank you for your attention, and please visit our project website for more information.